for Daddy, okay? You know how angry he gets. Now let's not make a scene.
I've been working nonstop since dawn. You wouldn't believe the conditions we're working under down here. Thank you.
I bet.
Acapulco's the third world, baby.
You working with Lonnie?
Yes, she's looking great, too.
Give her a hug for me, but not too big a one.
Okay. Lonnie!
Are you going to come home tonight so we can make babies?
Oh, honey, we're never going to be finished in time.
Don, you know this is my night. I don't care what the doctors say. I'm going to have a baby. Maybe I'm just going to see what Santa Claus can do about it.
He only visits good little girls.
Who visits good little girls? What's his number?
Have you been a good girl this year?
Yeah.
You obey your mommy?
Yeah.
Your daddy, too?
Yeah.
Oh, you're a good girl. You going to be a good girl all next year? All right, dear. Santa Claus will see you Christmas, okay?
We're getting there.
Oh, Lonnie, I miss you guys.
I miss you, too, hon. How's the shoot going up there?
It starts this afternoon.
Oop. We got to go. Crew's ready.
I love you. I'll see you tomorrow.
I love you, too. I really do love you.
And what do you want for Christmas, young man?
Honey, he's talking to you. Timmy, I'm sorry. Can we just have the cane? Thanks. Sorry, I'm scared. Come on. Oh, honey. Oh, did he scare you? Should Mama paint a smile on your face? Look at me. You got your cane. Look, you got a cane. Getting so heavy these days. You're gonna have to carry your mom. Oh, honey.
Doggy!
Wasn't breathing when we got to the scene.
No vital signs, and we haven't been able to resuscitate her. It's the damnedest thing. There's not a mark on her body. Now, this woman was hit by a cement truck, and she's still breathing.
You're not going to believe it when you look under that blanket.
Oh, God.
No blood pressure.
Epinephrine. Get Dr. Matthews' stat.
There are two of them, sir, just as protocol required. This one's got a heartbeat, but keeps slipping from us. The other one was DOA.
Look at this. What do you think? Put out the head man emergency call. Now.
I think we're all getting a little too keyed up here. And for heaven's sake, will somebody tell that woman to stop paging me? And Dr. Gordon.
Thanks, Art.
Okay, everyone's here.
Are we procedural?
Not yet.
We're waiting on a call from admissions.
What have we got?
All six protocol requirements either met or being met. First, we have an intact live brain in a 25 to 30-year-old Caucasian woman nearly transected by a cement truck. Now, her injuries are incompatible with sustained life. The fact that she's still alive testifies to a strong will to live, something that will stand her well in the months ahead.
If we proceed.
Correct, if we proceed.
Greenmeier. Right. Pete?
And the donor.
Second, we have a 25 to 30-year-old female Caucasian DOA, a probable cerebral aneurysm. Three doctors not connected with our team are confirming her death. Her husband is en route to the hospital.
Mary Frances, where is she?
I'm Bob Greenmeier, hospital administrator. This is Dr. Carlson, one of several doctors who've examined your wife.
Where is she?
You please come inside.
She's dead, isn't she?
I'm sorry.
Oh.
Blood workup indicates that the CPR perfused the donor body well enough to maintain all organ systems. She's now on cardiopulmonary bypass. Fourth, the entire headman team is present and accounted for.
Fifth. Do we have permission?
We've had no luck yet at locating the living woman's family, but here is the ultimate irony, gentlemen. She has an organ donor card. Our donor does not. It's up to her husband.
What's my boy do without his mama? What are we gonna do?
As difficult as this is for you to accept, Mr. Bodine, we must impose on you further.
What? You want from me?
Please listen carefully to what I'm about to tell you. There was another woman injured at the incident where your wife died. This woman's body suffered fatal injuries, but her brain is unharmed. She'll die without immediate surgery. And right now we have a team of surgeons assembled ready to perform a miraculous procedure which could save her.
What's it got to do with me?
Mr. Bodine, I know this will sound fantastic to you, but with your permission, they can place this woman's brain into your wife's body, and we believe this woman will have a chance to live. What you have to understand, however, is that your wife would be the donor, and with another woman's brain, she'll no longer be Mary Frances.
Are you out of your minds?
Mr. Bodine. Incredible as it may sound, this procedure, though experimental, has proved successful in every simulated run in primate trial.
I'm getting out of here.
Mr. Bodine! If you could bring yourself to do this thing, another woman can go on living because of your cooperation.
I can't think now. Yes, me tomorrow.
We wish we could. But unless we have your decision within literally minutes, it will be too late to proceed.
Thank God. You mean to say you can take another person's brain, put it in Mary Frances' body, and she can walk out of here and not be Mary Frances?
No. No. Recovery is very slow. Months. And if it's successful, the woman whose brain is in your wife's body will look like your wife. But her memory, her personality, and her emotions will be the other woman's.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Try to understand. I'm just a grease monkey.
See, Timmy, this is called Cat's
Excuse
Cradle.
Excuse me, ma'am. Come on, Timmy.
Sorry about your wife, Mr. Modine.
Yes, sir, me too.
At least the kid got out okay.
What do you mean, got out okay?
That other woman that got run over by the truck. She saved his life. Pushed him out of the way.
I want mommy.
Matthews. Great. Fine. Let him identify the body and then give him some time with the chaplain in case he changes his mind.
Thanks, Pete. Gentlemen, we can proceed. What's the matter, Dean?
I just can't help feeling that this could turn out to be an unhappy day for medicine. So be it.
No, wait. Why?
Who knows what God in his heaven thinks of all this? He may be reaching too high, Matt.
Official statement from the hospital confirming these reports, but this is a giant step forward in the history of human. Wait a minute, come on over here. Right, there's something going on up here. Hold
the
people.
What's the matter with you?
This might be the family.
Oh, sick man.
Please,
let us get through here, please.
Are you really the husband?
I don't know what you're talking about, lady.
Mr. North?
Yes. What in God's name is going on? Where's my wife? No one's told me anything.
I'm Bob Greenmeyer. I'm the hospital administrator. I'm sorry about the madhouse. Officers, I want some backup to keep that crowd under control. Every visitor is being harassed.
Yes.
Where's Julia?
I'd like to discuss her with you in Dr. Matthews' office. No one told you anything because nothing has been released.
The police said she wasn't dead.
Your wife is alive, Mr. North.
You experimented on my wife?
Without it, she would have died. If all goes well, she'll live.
As what? A freak? What right do you have? What right?
Mr. North, we tried to contact you. In the final analysis, Dr. Matthews' obligations were to his patient, Mrs. North, who was dying. Those obligations aside, your wife did carry a card, donating her body to research, education, and organ transplants. In this case, she has not only accomplished all three, but has possibly saved her own life in the process. All our facilities will be available for your wife's recovery and for your and her adjustment. We're well aware of the psychological implications.
What will she look like?
She looks like the woman who donated her body that your wife might live. You can see her tomorrow. But I want you to understand, her thoughts, her memories, her personality, her mannerisms, everything else will be the same as your wife.
If it works.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been an extremely busy time for us. This morning at 5:35 a.m., Dr. David Matthews and his surgical team completed the first cerebro-somatic anastomosis performed on a human being. This would commonly be referred to as a brain transplant. Now, for obvious reasons, the names of the donor and the recipient will be kept strictly confidential.
Now, wait a minute. This is the story of the century. How do you expect to maintain confidentiality?
Let me say this about that. I needn't belabor the profound psychological implications for our participants. Anyone trying to exploit or contact her, her family, or the donor's family will be interfering in our medical treatment and will face the maximum civil damages and criminal
David
charges.
David Lucas, Associated News. Dr. Matthews, how do you know the woman would have wanted the procedure done on her?
There is a well-established precedent for the saving of unconscious life. It's called implied consent. We assume the unconscious would want to live.
So you've decided life is exclusively in the brain?
No, the brain cannot maintain life without the body. What we recognize as awareness of life, consciousness, this reposes in the brain. In many ways, the body is like a container of this life.
How does the husband of the donor feel about his wife being used as a container?
The human body is the most remarkable container to be found in the universe. And in this context, I don't think the husband would object to the use of that word.
Marian Amberson, London Courier. How much time were the families given to make their decisions?
We were working with a 2 to 4 hour window during which the procedure had to be completed. The donor husband was forthcoming immediately.
John!
He could not be located until after the surgery.
What's wrong? Something wrong with Julia? What's happened? Don't you have to tell me?
We're brought to us by city paramedics who were called to the incident. To answer your question, no. Neither woman ever regained consciousness.
Mm. Doctor, suppose she doesn't want to live in another woman's body.
The question is valid. Do we offer an available, though radical, life-saving procedure to a Jane Doe? Or should she be left to die while we debate the pros and cons? Remember that for decades, we have had raging debate about abortion and life support systems. Yet we still haven't defined when life begins or when it ends. So if, while surgeons probe the mysteries of the body, the soul seems abandoned, it is not so. Feel quite confident in reassuring you, if you need such reassurance, that God in his infinite wisdom will watch out for the soul, especially on the eve of his son's birthday. Good night, and God bless this Jane Doe.
Now, because her immune system is suppressed, you'll view her through a window for the first weeks, and even that area is clean, so we'll put on caps and gowns and shoe covers.
Is she in pain?
That's a very good question, because the pain from this could be devastating. But we implanted EBS electrodes in her brain to stimulate the release of endorphins, which are the body's own painkiller. They'll keep her in a painless sleep until she's healed enough to awaken. The straps are to prevent any movement while the body's healing.
Daddy, you look.
She's all right, I guess.
That's not Julia. It's somebody else.
She can't hear you, Mrs. Deneen, but if she could, imagine her panic. That's not someone else. She will think like Julia, respond like Julia, laugh like Julia, cry like Julia, because she is Julia.
Will she sound like Julia?
The vocal cords will be different, But her inflection, accent, and choice of words will be the same, so you'll adjust to the new sound quickly. Remember, it will sound strange to her also. Since only her memory will be the same, you'll be her only link with her former self. To make this transition successfully, she'll need your help and love.
At the University Hospital at Claridge announce once again no change in the critical but stable condition of Jane Doe, the world's first brain transplant patient.
There is no precedent, and the claim is
Senator Roddy, may I finish, please?
The seat of consciousness is in the brain, and legal precedent establishes death not by heart failure, but by flat brain waves.
I need some things. You see the parents at the theater at 4:16. As soon as they do, let me...
May I help you?
Yeah, I'd like to see my wife.
Her name?
Mary Frances Bodine.
I have a right to see her. Jack, we explained all this to you before we proceeded. You signed the forms, you spoke with the chaplain. We couldn't have made it any clearer.
I'm no lawyer, no doctor. Even those guys on TV don't agree it ain't Mary Frances up there.
The overwhelming medical legal opinion comes down on the side that it's not Mary Frances up there.
I want to see her.
Jack, as confusing as it seems, it would only exacerbate matters. That's not in anyone's best interest.
All I want is Mary Frances!
Come in, now.
Can she have these?
Come on. Talk to her.
No, I can't.
Watch what you say. She may be able to hear you. She needs to hear you.
But I can't.
Let's try again.
No, I can't. Don't you understand? I want you to see Dr. Gordon.
Hey, I'm not the one that's crazy. You guys are crazy. You keep talking about my wife this, my wife that. Well, I'm sorry. I just don't believe it.
How do you like these roses, Julia?
Easy now. Easy now. Easy.
negative reaction.
Intense? Involuntary, but she smelled the roses. And that's the key. And we think she's capable of much more right now. Voluntary movement, a smile, a nod, a hand squeeze. But first, we need to turn off the EBS electrodes.
Isn't that what prevents her from feeling pain?
Exactly, but it's also blocking nearly all outside stimuli. She has no impulse to wake up, and we'd wean her from it if we could, but there's no dial that we can turn down. It's more like a switch that one must turn off.
It's a little late to be asking my permission.
No, we're asking your help, Don. You see, when the electrodes are turned off, Julia could go into a profound shock. Now, she needs a motivation strong enough to make her want to wake up instead of letting go. We hope that's you.
Dr. McCarty, dial 615.
We'll call you in when we're ready.
Dr. McCarty, dial 615.
Three minutes since disconnect.
Damn. Jules, you have nothing?
Nothing. Wait a minute, Matt.
There's a high amplitude reading, left caudate.
Motor and accessory areas gaining potential. There's definite movement.
She's trying to move, Matt. What do you see?
Nothing.
Keep watching.
Talk to her. Someone talk to her.
Julia, are you awake? My name is Dr. Matthews. I want you to move your hand, Julia.
She can hear you, Matt. I know she can.
And she can hear you, too. I think you better turn off the intercom. Have Kathy bring messages to us.
Julia, you've got to wake up now, Julia. You've been sleeping a long time. Wake up, Julia.
Dr. Matthews, Dr. Haverford thinks she might be able to see if you open her eyelids.
Julia? Are you listening? I'm going to open your eyes. I'm reaching down now. And now I'm touching your lids. She's going into shock.
She's losing consciousness, Matt.
Kathy, 1 gram solucortef. Stat, open up those fluids. Gordon, get Don in here. Julia, wake up, Julia.
If Don sees her the way we just did, he'll never come around.
She's giving up. Get him in here.
We're losing her.
Julia, wake up, Julia.
He's stabilizing. 50 over 30.
Don, come in here. Come on, I need you.
Talk to her, see if you can reach her.
Now.
Julie.
Pressure, 50 over 30.
Damn it, man, talk to her. Talk to her.
Julie? Wake up. Please, Julia. It's me. It's Don. Don't leave me now.
That's it. Go on.
Julia. Please, wake up. I want to talk to you. Your mom and dad want to talk to you. Julia?
We're getting some activity back.
Blood pressure 70 over 40.
I think she can feel that.
Julia, please wake up. I've been lonesome. I want you to hold me again.
85 over 50. Better. Much better.
Jules?
What's wrong?
She's squeezing my hand.
And bounds are the enthusiastic words being used by doctors to describe the progress made by Jane Doe, the world's first brain transplant patient. Hospital sources also report an overwhelming outpouring of Valentine cards and telegrams from all over the world for Jane Doe.
You're not supposed to be in here, sir.
I'm sorry, Dr. Matthews wanted maintenance.
I beg your pardon? You can't go in there.
Mary Frances? Who is that?
I don't know. He said you sent for him. I couldn't stop him.
It's Bodine. Jack?
You guys lied to me. She's alive.
Jack, this is rough on you. Come out with me, and I'll tell you everything you want to know.
I want to look at her.
Let's do as I suggested, Jack. I'm the physician in charge.
I said I want to see her. It's her birthday. Valentine's Day. Well, that's an easy one. Me and Timmy sure missed her. Has she hurt or anything?
No. She's asleep.
All the time?
Yes. Let's go now. Come on.
Put the size down so I can kiss
her. She must not be touched!
When can I take her home?
Right, thanks. We now have full-time security stationed outside the monitor room. No one unconnected with the case will be admitted without clearance.
And Jack Bodine isn't connected with the case?
Definitely not. An organ donor is not part of the recipient's family.
And we can seek a restraining order on him if it comes to that.
That's great. We have every technical, psychological, and legal resource of the California University System poised to persuade Jack Bodine that the woman in the bed who looks like his wife is actually a perfect stranger. Guess who the whole country will line up on?
Would a meeting between the two husbands be useful?
That might change his perspective, yeah. But it may only be Julia North who can prove to Jack who she is.
She's crying.
No. Dr. Matthews says that a chemical imbalance is stimulating the tear ducts. Now, he promised she's not really crying.
Don't cry, sweetheart. Daddy's here.
What are you doing?
When she'd cry, she'd sound like a fire engine. So I'd make like a fire engine, and she'd laugh.
Mr. North, Dr. Gordon just called to say that Mr. Bodine is here.
All righty, thank you.
Well, what's he doing here?
Dr. Gordon feels that meeting me will help him face reality.
Why can't I see Dr. Matthews?
What would you like to see him about?
Oh, I just thought he might like to say he's sorry, that's all.
For what?
Saying Mary Frances isn't my wife.
Come in. Jack, this is Don, the husband.
Yeah, I know.
I want to thank you for what you've done. I know what a sacrifice you made.
So what do we do now? We sit around and cry?
Well, what we'd like to bring to the surface here is quite simple. How do you feel about each other? Don?
I feel grateful, as I said. I guess I'm a little awed by your ability to do what you did. I could never have given my wife's body away, no matter what.
I didn't give Mary Frances away. They tricked me anyway. It's not legal. She'll come back to me.
Wait a minute.
Jack, I believe that when our patient awakens, she'll want to be with her husband.
That's right, and that's me.
You know you're not the husband. We've been over this so many times these past weeks.
And what's it got me? Nothing. But you get Mary Frances, and you get your publicity. And Timmy and me?
Listen, we understand how difficult this is for you. Let's just continue to try.
Oh, let's just don't continue. I can't take this anymore. I'm getting out of here.
You know, maybe I'll go back to Texas.
The worst thing I ever did was leave Texas, but that was Mary Frances' idea. Just like Timmy was her idea, just like everything's been her idea. I don't even know what I've been crying about. Damn you. Damn her.
And then there were Sunday mornings. We had the whole day planned.
and I'd have to come and rustle you out of bed like now. Remember? Wake up. Come on, wake up. Get out of bed. Wake up. Come on, wake up. You sleepyhead. Sing, jump, laugh, and be happy when the red, red robin comes bobbing along. Along, there'll be no more sobbing when he starts singing his old sweet song. Wake up. Wake up. You sleepyhead.
Wake
up. Wake up. Wake up. Get out of bed.
Bed.
Sing.
Sing. Jump.
Be happy.
Happy.
When the red, red robin comes. Pop, pop, pop.
Pop, pop, and then home. Down. Sobbing.
She would. Did she talk?
Vaguely. Slipping in and out of coherency. But she was coherent enough to start asking the right or wrong questions. That's why I stayed.
Gosh. Tell me, how do you feel about Don?
Don?
Yeah.
He's really come around. Why?
He says he wants to be the one to tell Julia what's happened. Matt, he feels it's his responsibility, and he doesn't want us to usurp it.
Okay. I can accept that.
And he doesn't want us to be there.
Wait a second. What if he precipitates a crisis?
He says he'll take responsibility.
The hell he will. We've got a stake in this, too. Who does he think he is all of a sudden?
Her husband.
Julie? Julie? Julie, will you wake up? I need to talk to you. Julia? Do you remember me? Can you talk to me, please?
I'm soft.
How do you feel?
Fine. How do you feel?
I feel great.
Great.
Do you feel like talking about what happened? No, leave that. Dr. Matthews will take that off pretty soon, okay? That's it. No. I want you to listen to me, okay?
Okay.
You look different, but you're still the same inside, and I still feel the same way about you as ever. The doctors performed an incredible operation to save you. They had to move your brain into another body. Julia?
Julia?
Yes.
Tom? I love you.
I want you to hurry up and get well so we can go home together.
Hand?
Yes.
Hand. Hand.
It's all right.
Hand.
It's all right. It's all right.
Hand.
No,
hurry me, please. I have to go.
It's all right.
Who's talking? Who's talking? I'm here. I'm fine. I'm here. I'm fine.
Yes.
I have to go now, please. Okay?
It's all right.
Whose voice is that? Daddy, please. Don't.
Julia.
Joe.
Julia, it's all right.
Please, Daddy.
Oh, it's all right.
I have to go now.
You're about 5'6", and you weigh about 120 pounds or so as soon as we get some meat and potatoes into you. Your hair is lovely. It's a warm brown, almost a walnut color.
Let me see. My eyes are blue. Are you alone?
Sure.
You're alive, honey. That's the important thing, and everyone is so glad that you are alive.
Can I have a scarf?
What I'll do when I hear a voice. Just hope she's all right in the head. Poor baby.
She is.
All we can do is wait and see.
She's not in her right mind. She'd be better off dead.
Don't. Don't ever let her hear you talking like that.
Hi.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Daddy.
Hi there, young lady. You're looking pretty chipper.
Thank you.
Julia,
I feel better.
So good to hear you talk. I can hardly believe you're with us. Oh, darling.
Well, you look great. They look great, don't they?
Yes, they do.
Daddy, you're thinner. Mom, how does he feel?
Not so great. The doctors say there's nothing. It's just worry, I guess.
Don't worry about me, Dad, now. I stand against everything.
It's all right. It's all right. The words just don't come out in the proper order sometimes, but that'll pass.
It's no wonder she gets a little mixed up with all that's happened to her.
I saw the doll.
Did she say doll? Don, why don't you get the doctor?
It's all right. I'm listening. Why?
Her forehead feels warm.
Come on.
She's a little warm.
Come on, Mother. We're wearing her out.
I hope you feel better soon, darling. You simply have to get her some clothes. That gown is dreadful.
Upset. Your mom doesn't always think before she speaks.
Like my.
Yeah, just like you.
Hey, I got your present.
You see, I act before your mom can think or speak.
Oh, Don. Oh, it's beautiful. It's just beautiful. I love it. I love it. I just love it.
try it on.
What? No. No, I want to wash up first and, you know, do it right. You come back?
Of course.
Good.
See you later.
Everybody out.
Don't. Please don't. It hurts so much. Please, I want the doctor.
I'm here, Jimmy.
I want the doctor, please, okay?
I'm here.
Please let me die. I want to die. I want to die. Because I can't stand her body. I hate it.
That's understandable. It'll change.
I can't help it. I can't help it. I feel so separate. Please don't go.
I won't.
Do you have a wife?
No.
If you did, would you operate on her?
I don't know. If you'd asked me before, I'd have said yes. But I thought it would be easier than it's been for you.
I tried to kill her.
Julia, I'm so sorry. I was so sure you'd want another chance at life when they brought you into the hospital. And I was so proud that...
give it to you.
I do want to live. I just don't know how. I can't get inside her body.
Well, sure you can. You're there now.
No.
When you cry, you make tears come out of her eyes. When you want comfort, your hand comes out to me. You make the corners of her lips smile. And those eyes. See, I saw them before you were there. And they were cold and gray. And now, with the way they look at me, they're the most beautiful eyes I've ever seen. I love those eyes.
I don't think you should do this again.
Are you sure? Because I and the whole world will be listening to you on that.
Well, maybe if you could ask the person first, maybe then it would be all right.
What would you have said?
Yes.
Triceps and biceps reflexes are normal. Brachial radialis reflex within normal limits. Sensory innervation fully restored, T1 to L5.
Never used to be ticklish.
I am now.
Implanted tickle electrode still functioning. Well, well. I take it we're not here for your daily stress test.
I wanted the atmosphere to be less clinical for this.
And what exactly is this?
I want you to tell me all about Mary Frances.
How do you know her name?
Dawn. Tell me, Matt.
I'm with Drs. Chung and Haverford, Matt. I think you've got to let her go.
She's just not ready for that kind of stress. She still shows aphasia. She's easily frightened.
But there's no guarantee she'll ever get past that point.
Certainly not until she's confident with who she really is. And that won't be resolved until she's confronted the outside world.
Your results may be less than perfect, Matt. We see damaged people every day. You can't expect to do better than the Lord.
Garage.
Looks pretty scary out there.
It's the same place you came in from 6 months ago.
Matt. I can come visit you, can't I? And see everybody.
I couldn't bear not to see you again. I'm very fond of you.
I know. It makes me feel good and wanted. I'm all right to the worries when she comes.
It's my girl.
Thank you.
Here she comes.
Here she comes.
Thank you. One more time?
No. No more.
I'll call you when I have lunch.
Okay.
Okay.
Good luck.
Come back.
Sorry, again, Julie.
Thank you for your courage, Julie.
Thank you. Had good taste in clothes. Where are the old ones, Don? And the pictures?
In the garage. Picked out most of this stuff while you were in the hospital.
Not this one.
Well, I didn't want doctors and nurses to know everything I had in my mind.
Gonna drink this with the lights off. Welcome home.
This is so like you. Cheers.
That sounded just like you. That was stupid of me. Yeah.
I'm sorry about the negligee. I guess I'm just not ready.
It's all right.
Can we snuggle a little bit?
Sure.
I'm not even a perfect fit anymore.
Are allowed to pass down public roads.
Why does it stop at our house?
It didn't stop.
It slowed down.
So soon.
I just gotta go shopping. Get some food. I'll be okay.
Why don't you come down to the set? And we're doing a great spread on some evening wear.
I'm just not ready yet.
I'm working with Lonnie. Well, she really wants to see you. I mean, they all do. You wouldn't let any of them visit you while you were in the hospital.
Come on.
Well, maybe I'll stay home today.
No. No, I can take care of myself. I just need to get myself in some kind of routine.
Some cases of brainstem trauma, information from the body is blocked from reaching the cortex. And this can lead to feelings of panic, of paranoia, persecution. I suspect that that's the problem here, and it'll pass as the nerve pathways reroute themselves.
Is that why I don't believe Don is sincere with me? I mean, even his touching me. My first night home, he was all over me.
And that angers you?
That he could take a strange woman into our bed and make love to her using the same words and the same touches that he used to use with me? Yeah. I mean, is that how little I meant to him?
What strange woman did he make love to?
Me. With this Mary Frances body.
And who are you?
Come on, Dr. Gordon. I haven't even figured this thing out yet. Now, how could he know?
He's had a long head start. Have you talked about it?
No. My whole life before revolved around my looks, my image. Now, I don't know what to do with myself.
Is it possible that your marriage was based on your image, too?
I don't know anymore. I don't even know who's Julia.
You are Julia.
Thank you.
couldn't bring myself to get off on that floor again.
Julia.
Trust me?
It's not you I don't trust.
Well, I don't trust anyone. I don't. The only time I'm not scared is when I'm with you. Outside of here, I don't know who Julia is.
What does Gordon say about this?
He talked about brain stem injury, but I know what it is. I've lost control over my life. The surgery without my permission. People telling me what to do, telling me where to go and how to feel. And the less control I have, the less I know who I am. I'm not even allowed to love who I want, am I? That is how little control I have.
And who is it that you want to love?
I don't know. Don. You.
And why me, you think?
Aside from the fact that you're extremely handsome, you have a sensational bedside manner, and you saved my life?
No. Think like a doctor. You've been around them enough.
Because I've grown dependent on you. Well, what if I don't want to grow independent?
But you must.
Why must I?
Because being totally dependent upon another person is not living. And it's not love.
Then help me grow independent. Please.
All right. For months, Don was terrified that he would not be able to love you in another body. Now, Gordon and I told him to give you a chance, and he did. He stood by you, and he pulled you through. Now it's your turn.
Well, I want to give him that chance. I do.
Well,
why do you love me?
Okay, let's move it along, everybody. Okay. Air is beautiful, thank you. Are we ready? That's good, that's good. Do that again. Up. All right.
Look over your shoulder.
There you go. More thigh or they won't buy. That's it.
That's it.
Okay, good. Yes. Now let's try for something sexy this time, okay? All right. Okay, change into the red dress. Check the hair and makeup, please. Ladies, relax.
She looks great, doesn't she?
Hey! Oh, I'm so glad you came.
Lonnie looks really good.
Yes, she does. I wish you told me you were coming. I could have told everyone.
Don North, what would Julia say?
Well, she'd say she loves her husband, Lonnie.
I'm sorry, have we met?
Lonnie, this is...
Julia. I'm sorry, I didn't recognize you.
Well, how could you? I dyed my hair. Hi, Lonnie.
Got it. It's you.
Mm-hmm.
Good to have you back.
No, don't let go.
I gotta change now. We'll talk later, okay?
Okay.
It's
afraid to see me.
So embarrassed and upset, she tried to call. What are you doing?
I found it in the garage.
Don't do this to me.
Take it off.
You say that as if it doesn't belong to me.
It doesn't. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
Yes, you did.
I didn't. It's just... it's sick. It's morbid. Why are you doing this to me?
How come you never call me Julia? Huh? How come you never call me Julia? You haven't called me Julia since we've been home. No wonder the hospital felt more like home than this. They knew who I was. They treated me like Julia.
And Dr. Matthews treated you like his girlfriend?
What?
The reason I never call you Julia anymore. It's because the only time I ever saw the old Julia was when he walked into the room.
Maybe because he was always excited to see me, to see who I was each day at a time. You were scared to see me, and you wanted something other than what I was, and you still do.
He was excited to see his experiment.
You're the one that makes me feel like an experiment.
Well, then why don't you go to Dr. Matthews? Get out of here. Trying very hard to be loving and understanding. But it's hard when she's in love with you.
It's not totally unexpected in a situation like this. We discussed this today, and we're trying to redirect her feelings toward you.
But you encouraged it in the first place.
No, Don. It can be a fine line between caring and nurturing and loving and falling in love with patients, but we never crossed that line. I promise you. Julia needed and needs all the love she can get.
You're strangers to each other. We're strangers emotionally, physically, every which way.
Come on. Julia's a stranger to herself, searching for some validation, some identity. That's what makes her so vulnerable right now.
You all right in there? Need help?
My car is stuck. I'm tired. I just want to go home.
Sure. I'll take you home, Mary Frances. Please.
No.
I need to see you. Please let me talk to you.
Why are you following me?
They kept me away from you like I hurt you or something. I needed to talk to you. Why wouldn't they let me talk to you?
Well, I don't know why. It's strange. Maybe I need to talk to you, too. I only look like her.
Sure do. You even smell like her, feel like her. Please come home to Timmy.
Timmy?
People can talk you into anything, but nobody can tell you you're not his mother. The one who gave birth to him, the one who nursed him, he'll know, you'll know. Mary Frances, you gotta tell him. You gotta tell him something. Please come home with me.
I can't.
Please, for Timmy's sake. And then if you want to leave, you tell him you have to go away forever, and then you can leave. I promise. Let me push you out. And you can follow me. No strings. For the boy. Please.
Why can't I feel anything anymore?
Perhaps because you've been trying to feel the wrong things. See, old stirrings and old sensations may not exist anymore. I mean, we don't know how much of that may have been lost with Julia's body. But that's not love. That's not real love.
What do you call it, then?
I don't know. But I do know that real love grows from shared experience and from sharing what's in the depths of another person's soul. And you and Julia have that still. You have a foundation. Forget about trying to feel old stirrings. They won't be there. But, Don, new stirrings lie ahead.
Why didn't you teach us this before?
You and Julia have just taught it to me.
Mrs. Shula, thank you.
Not a peep out of him, Jack. Good night.
Night. In on him.
He's in here. Please.
Jim.
Tammy, look who's here.
Dr. Matthews, Dr. Gordon stopped by the hospital for the photographs.
Doc, there's nothing here to lead me to believe that this is anything other than a domestic situation.
Well, that doesn't matter. This woman is in need of medical care and she must be found immediately.
That's why we're here, Doc. That's why we're here.
Hey, maybe these will help.
No, thank you. Do you have anything more personal?
No. Do you remember El Paso?
I hate chickens.
You always did. You better put him to bed. Smile on his face.
What do you mean?
The way he used to.
Jack, don't.
Please, baby. Please, baby. Let things be the way they used to. Don't let them change you.
Jack, no.
Okay.
Please don't.
Can't you?
Please don't, okay?
You can feel it.
Please stop. Jack, please. Please stop it. Stop it.
You want me. You want me. I know you do. I can feel it.
Stop it.
Put something else on, something warm.
No, I'm fine, really.
Well, let's wait.
I'm fine. I have to go.
You used to wear it in bed. I mean, Mary Frances did.
No, I can't. But thank you.
Oh, lady. Are you sure? I know you felt something when you held Timmy. And when I held you, I know you did.
This body felt something. I don't understand it either. But I know I'm not your Mary Frances. I am Julia North.
What about being a mother to Demi? He doesn't know the difference, can't you be?
You still don't want to give her up, do you? She's dead, Jack. She's gone.
Oh, lady. I understand cars. I sure understand cars.
Come here, buddy. Okay. I have to go now, Timmy.
No!
But your mommy wants you to know that she loves you so very much. She always has. And she always will. Goodbye, sweetheart.
Come on. Let go, Timmy. Timmy, let go. Let go, buddy. Stay with Dad, son. He needs you, boy.
I'm home now.